Hello everyone and welcome to this session. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the implementation of bandpass filtering of an image while working into the frequency domain using the MATLAB software. So here the MATLAB software is available to us. Let us switch to the editor window for programming purpose. So I will start writing the code with the syntaxes of close all, clear and CLC so that we can start with the fresh execution of our program. Adding one comment line to mention what is motive behind writing this particular program. So I just write, this is a program to demonstrate the frequency domain bandpass filtering of an image. So this is what the simple aim we need to accomplish. So for that purpose, first of all, we need to have the image available in the MATLAB environment. That can be made possible by the reading input image. So let us write read the input image as the first module. I will generate a variable A that will hold the image information and that will access the image information with the MATLAB syntax I am read from the current folder, where whatever the image data sets we have here in the current folder, its particular name along with the file type we need to specify in a pair of single quote. So here I am going to make the use of very popular image data set cameraman.tif. I end the syntax with the help of semicolon here. Let us save this particular script with the name, for example, program_21.m is the file extension. I have saved it. You can check in the current folder, the file name has appeared. As well, the name has appeared onto the editor window tab, what it was initially untitled. Now, as I run this particular program in the workspace that it was initially empty, we will get the variable A with cameraman.tif information. So here we are having capital A with the dimensions 256 by 256 of the data type uint8. Now after successfully reading the image to the MATLAB environment for further processing, we shall continue our programming. Now for generation of the bandpass filter function, I will like to have generation of the two variables that will be helpful. Those will be assigned the dimensions of the input image, and that is possible with the help of the MATLAB syntax size, where I provide the input argument capital A that has holded up the information of input image to be processed here. So now it's time to have defining the filter kernel. So for defining the filter kernel, I initiate the variable capital H to hold a matrix of zeros of the same size as that of the input image. That is why I have provided zeros in the parenthesis m comma n. I will make the use of nested for loop to generate this filter kernel. First of all, with the variable I that will span for the pixel intensities, the pixel location from 50 to let us say 200. Next to that, inside it I will nest one more for loop that will iterate for j value again 50 to 200 as we are generating it for the purpose of bandpass filtering here. Thereupon the filter function that it was initiated with all the values in the matrix of zeros here, so h of I comma j, we will assign the value 1 here. We will end the for loopings. Now next to that, as we have to work for the bandpass filtering, so there should be a specific region limit. That is why I again start with the for looping for the variable I to run with the values 100 to 150, nesting another for loop with the variable j that will iterate to start with again 100 to 150 value. Hereupon I will specify the value of h of I comma j that is equal to 0 here, now ending with the nested for loops. So with the two nested for loops, we have generated the filter mask for bandpass filtering here. Now we need to apply it onto the image. As we intend to have operation of bandpass filtering onto the image while working into the frequency domain, we will like to shift the image information in the frequency domain. So I write a comment to modularize our script. Shift the image to frequency domain. So here I am going to generate a variable a underscore f that we can obtain by applying direct Fourier transformation of two dimensional signal, that is FFT2, onto the input image that is stored in variable capital A. Now it's time to apply the filter here. So I just write applying the frequency domain filter. So the filter is of band pass type. So for that purpose, what we need to do, we need to shift the frequency domain filter representation as well. So I will generate h underscore f with the help of FFT shift for the earlier representation of the filter kernel denoted by capital H. Now I will have a multiplication of the two and will store it with the variable capital B. So a underscore f dot multiplication with h underscore f here. So dot multiplication in the frequency domain is nothing but the convolution into the spatial domain here. Now as the result of this bandpass filtering is stored into capital B, this is a frequency domain information, so we need to get it back to the spatial domain. So for that purpose, we need to perform the inverse Fourier transformation of two dimensional signal with the help of IFFT2 command. The absolute of it will be stored with the variable C. Here input argument is capital B from the above step here. So this completes our operating the image by bandpass filtering while we operated it in the frequency domain. Now the last module will be to have the display of input and output images. So hereupon I am going to make the use of subplot command, where I will generate two rows, two columns. The first cell I will make the visualization displayed for the original image that we have stored into the variable A, therefore providing the concerned title that it is original image. By the next line I will go for accessing the next cell of the subplot, so 2, 2, 2. Here I will like to have the display of the filter function. So if I am making it displayed with the help of imshow command, it will have a two dimensional representation of that particular filter function. So this is, I am providing title 2D view of capital H. By the next line, along with the two dimensional visualization, I will go for displaying the three dimensional visualization that is possible in MATLAB with the help of SURF command. Again the input argument will be capital H. The concerned title here I am going to provide, so 3D view of capital H. At last I go for subplot 2, 2, 4, where last cell will be accessed here, and with the help of imshow command I will like to have display of the resultant, that means the output image after filtering. So that is stored into the variable C, but it will be of the data type double. So for making the use of imshow command, you need to get it back converted to uint 8 type. So the concerned title, after getting it converted, I'm providing here. So this is what the image after bandpass filter, I will abbreviate as BPF, in frequency domain. So this is what a simple program we have written here. We will save this particular script. We will run it. So in the workspace, you see, initially we had only variable capital A to hold the input image to be processed here, that it was cameraman.tif. The image information shifted to frequency domain. After application of filter in the frequency domain, we get capital B. After getting it inverse transform, the representation, we get to the spatial domain. So complex double representation is for the data that we have in the frequency domain, while double here we have back to the spatial domain. So the concerned subplot here, it is displayed. I maximize the window. As this is bandpass filter, this much of particular portion in the filter function will be allowed to appear into the output image. Rest of the portion that you see with the black color is not at all allowed here. So this is what the three-dimensional visualization. I will try to maximize it so that you can see it better. So you can see the portion between this particular region is allowed to get appeared into the output. For the input image, cameraman.tif, that is regarded as original image here, and this is the output image here. So if I change the input image, instead of having cameraman.tif, if I make it to lena.jpg, saving the changes, running the script again, so you get the concerned output like this here. So manually you can have the construction of the bandpass filter by the nested for loops used like this. So you can vary the range so that you can construct the bandpass filter, but it should not go beyond the dimensions of the input image. Here it was 256 for both the dimensions, so that I have taken 50 to 200, and in that span I have again subtracted 100 to 150. So that way I have got the results. So that result I have already discussed with you. So a simple demonstration of bandpass filtering of image in the frequency domain working I have shown you. Thank you.